It's no secret that the majority of engine wear occurs during startup when the engine is cold as it's coming up to temperature. And this is the reason why we see teams running high-end race vehicles will generally preheat both the water and the oil. Now, there is a old wives' tale that the likes of Formula One engines where we see this operation being undertaken is because the tolerances or clearances inside the engine are so tight that if this wasn't done, the engine wouldn't turn over. Now, that's just not the truth. And if you think about the practicalities of actually assembling the engine, clearly we're going to need to be able to turn the engine over when it is at room temperature. However, the clearances inside the engine will change dramatically from ambient temperature through to running temperature. So preheating everything just gets all of those clearances where they need to be, helping to eliminate wear. We're here at World Time Attack to look at an interesting application of a water preheater. This specific one is from P1 Racing Components in Australia, and it's installed on the Xtreme GTR R32 Nissan Skyline. Now, what this does is plugs into the cooling system and it draws water out of the front of the engine block, and then it runs it through the P1 unit. This includes both a 240 volt heater element as well as a small pump to actually move the fluid, the coolant, through the system, and then returns the heated water into the radiator. Now, over the course of around about 45 minutes to an hour of preheating, this will get the engine coolant temperature from ambient up to around 60 or 70 degrees C. Now, at the same time, this is obviously only part of the challenge because we also need to consider the oil. Given that this particular car runs a dry sump system, it's relatively easy to use a powered electric heating element wrapped around the dry sump tank or an inserted probe that also heats the oil through inside of the dry sump tank, depending on the specific preference of the team. Now, what this does is allows the engine to be heated thoroughly so that when it is started for the first time, everything is close to normal operating temperature, reducing wear and making sure that the clearances are where they should be. Another element that goes hand in hand with this as well is making sure that before the engine fires for the first time, that the engine has oil pressure. And particularly if we start cranking the engine and it fires almost instantly, we may find that if we're monitoring oil pressure, it takes between 1 and 3 seconds for sensible or normal oil pressure to be registered. In this instance, the team get around this by disabling fuel injection for the first 5 or so seconds of cranking when the engine is started for the first time at an event. This allows the dry sump pump to build up oil pressure, make sure that oil is flowing everywhere before the engine fires up for the first time. And it's just these small details that can vastly improve the reliability and life expectancy of what can sometimes be an incredibly expensive engine.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.